I think it reminded me of Forrest Gump, who said that life is like a box of chocolate, and you never know what you're going to get. And sometimes, you see, that's the way it is with children. But children are not pancakes that you throw the first one out and then you're trying to get it in the shape. The children come to us with lots of gifts and lots of challenges. So there is something between birth and death, or life. I think some people live a lifestyle, and lifestyle means more life. Temptation is here to stay, like David Jones. Why? So we can practice the freedom of choice. Our children nowadays are exposed to everything. It's much harder for them than it was in our times. And many of them choose a lifestyle. They start smoking and drinking and running very, very, very early. I think the American families should learn a lot from yours. I think you have much closer families. When I was in Monterey, Moshe Sandler, anybody knows Moshe Sandler? I was a president of YPO many, many years ago, I met him. I spoke at the American school. They were the most polite, beautiful students, and that's what I experienced today. I am taking antibiotics, so I need to come and get a little water once in a while, but I'm going to do all I can. I also met the teachers and the principals this morning. And Sharon and your husband, please stand up behind me, please. Yeah, Daddy, please stand up. Yes, they're the most wonderful Toastmasters. One of the teachers teaches philosophy, and I am a Buber freak, and she and I talked about Martin Buber. Martin Buber was a young man, and he was going to sell his books, and someone approached him and wanted to get his attention. And Buber says, "Can't you see I'm very busy? I am selling my books," and told the man to just evaporate. And that young man went home and took out the revolver and shot himself. And then Buber found out what happened. His whole life had changed, and he developed the theory of the I am now versus the I am it. He said, "The book is it, and I could have saved my life." So I feel tonight the same way, that I'm going to call you down, and I'm going to really just respect you and recognize that without you I wouldn't be here tonight. And how we can maybe turn this into a dialogue. Martin Buber also was walking on the street with a friend, and someone came by, and the friend asked Buber, "Do you know that person?" And Buber said, "Not enough to share silence with him." So when you get married, now let's talk about love, shall we? You know, falling in love, it's a chemical high that the only people get from chocolate. It has nothing to do with love. I'm not knocking it. I mean, it can lead to a big relationship. But many times, the more the romance you have before marriage, you wake up one day and stay apart in any way, because that romantic love goes away. So I think many times we fall in love like we fall into a hole, and then we fell out of love, and we fell out of a tree. And it's very hard for the children, because they are not born with a job to take care of the parents and see who is going to come home and lose my hair. I'm very much asking you to acknowledge that when you yell, your children are going to have a real hard time because that child is thinking that he or she is not good enough. So that's what I do. I teach parents how to be good parents. But the best thing you can do, perhaps, is to be a good parent to yourself, because it's impossible to get. I spoke to 5,608 leaders in Austin, Texas, and they didn't realize how pivoted they are. They call each other queer and stupid and you name it. There is no bad girl or bad boy. No labels. There is no such thing. We are all good boys and good girls. I remember having a friend, and she said, I'm looking outside, and I see people killing each other, and I still want to believe that people are basically good. What we do, of course, the only thing I can change is the behavior. So I had a lonely childhood. I was painfully shy. But maybe God put me in a family where I could spend a lot of time alone. And I was prepared to have my inner resources that I bring you today. To dig deeper, and that's what you are doing here. I hear of many people who are in need, and you are supporting them, and you're not letting your sisters and brothers down. Congratulations for that. I ended up in a place called Queensland Camp. I had a book on it when cannibals broke out and the people were eating other people's flesh. That's when I turned to God as well. I remember sharing the story with Moshe Dayan when I was in Israel doing my research for my doctoral dissertation. And Moshe Dayan and I were sharing stories, and he said he had similar stories to tell. Because I looked down and I had a street, and I remember choosing one blade of grass over and against the other. So when people tell me I can't is not in my vocabulary. Just take the apostrophe and take the T and say I can. Why? Because I think I can. Just like a choo-choo thing. I think I can. And see what kind of goal you want to set up. And then see what you're focusing on. And see what you are. What is you focusing on? Is it in alignment to where you want to go? Because people are really happier with our goals. I was thinking we did before. 1945, by the 71st Infantry. But I also remember that people were going through the gate. And then they don't come back. The freedom is very scary, because when you're free, you can't get past the block. If you have a child who's asking for a 40-year-old question, 40-year-old question is a why question. Why is this? Why is that? Why is that? So if you have adults who's going to come with why question, just be careful, because you're still talking to a child. And why you bring in, who's their child? So I like to write constitutions for families. There is no blame, only responsibility. And I make deals with the children. That there is like a Chinese laundry man, no taking, no washing. There is no freedom without responsibility. And then there is no punishment in a family, only consequence. It works very well. America has a constitution. You can write your own family constitution, and then you're not the top dog and the underdog. But the minute you get frustrated, mommy, remember that the children see your push buttons, and they know exactly which button to push, because children gain a lot of power when they are frustrated and helpless. So